It's becoming more and more obvious to me. As time's going on, it's taken me a long time to resolve this. It's taken me a long time to come in and to see this. I could never understand why anyone would have the brass neck to call themselves a disciple of Jesus Christ and then live contrary to Jesus Christ. How is it this monstrous filth called church flouts God's ordinance, flouts his law, this isn't suggestions, flouts his ways, spits on Jesus Christ and yet continues in the name of Jesus Christ? But I know now. It's taken me a long, long time to resolve this. But something the Lord's been showing me lately, and is increasingly so, is that when Satan is unveiled, probably in his palace in Rome, is the GPS position of his revelation is not really the important issue. That is Satan's palace in Rome. And the Satan's right-hand man, the vicar of Satan, old the Antichrist, as he's been known by Christians for a long, long time, is ultimately, when he's unveiled there, it'll all be as Jesus Christ. Now, all people have been conditioned for decades now, probably maybe as long as 70 or 80 years. People have been conditioned by people like wicked people, like Billy Graham and Oral Roberts and scum like that. They're not disciples of Jesus Christ. They're not with him. If they're not with him, as the Lord Jesus said quite plainly, you're with me or you're against me. He said quite plainly through John, James chapter 4, he said quite plainly in James chapter 4 that friendship with the world, the body of Satan, is enmity with God. Whosoever be a friend of the world is the enemy of God. I am quite sure that when Satan is revealed, being the cynical bastard that he is, he's going to be claiming to be all love and sweetness and light and all-inclusive and lovey-dovey and romantic sentimental love, not God's love at all. God is love, but not that kind of love. But nevertheless, all-inclusive, and it's all going to be a 3.5 years of wonderful stuff, which is why they're crying peace and safety, as Jesus said they would be when he came suddenly in power. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1. He's coming in flaming fire and vengeance to destroy the wicked. To come against those who know not God, knowing Satan, the god of this world, small g, and the ultimate Antichrist, isn't good enough. You've got to know the one true living God. But unfortunately, we've got two Jesuses. And I mentioned this in a previous video. Satan has set himself up via that monster called church. He set himself up as Jesus Christ. He's got a whole another Jesus that Paul wrote about in the second letter to the church at Corinth, the brethren at Corinth. He spoke, if any man come to you preaching another Jesus who we've not preached to you, etc., etc. You know the passage. Another Jesus? Why does Satan set himself up as another Jesus? Well, it's because he can draw off all these Christians after another Jesus. Their Jesus is licentious, debauched, and he loves filth and sin. He accommodates depravity. He loves the putrid, the debauched, and the depraved. You know, he's not against sick and wicked religion like Hinduism, Roman Catholicism, Islam. He comes as Jesus Christ. Actually, it's Satan in a Jesus suit. This isn't Jesus Christ himself at all, unfortunately. Sadly, the vast bulk of humanity are going to be going after Satan when he comes as an angel of light, notice, remember. But So you've got two Jesuses now. This is not a contention between a black, scaly creature with a tail and horns. He's not like that at all. He was an angel of light, a high angel, Lucifer, the son of the morning. They sing hymns to him in Latin, in his palace in Rome. They do, yeah, really they do. So when he comes as a cynical blighter that wants to come and take command and control of the world, which I think is what he's going to do, just like the pattern of the Tower of Babel, he's going to come as Lord of the earth, pretending to be Jesus Christ. Most people are going to go after him who are Christians because they've been conditioned to that Jesus who is licentious and forgiving and loving and no rules, no regulations, no discipline, nothing like that whatsoever. He doesn't rebuke people for being wrong. And oh dear, what a wicked man that Paul was when he told Titus to rebuke the Cretans that they might be sound in the faith. But sadly, unfortunately, the bulk of people have gone for the wrong Jesus completely. And that wrong Jesus is Satan in a Jesus suit. And when he comes, because he's speaking according to the world and he is Satan, it will chime with everything in them. At that point, possibly he'll dispense with church completely and get rid of it all. But we'll see what actually happens. But nevertheless, we got one Jesus who's completely licentious, debauched, and totally unlike the Jesus you see in the scripture. And then you've got the Jesus that we see in the scripture, who's the same from the creation and the same sat on his judgment throne at the end of time. Exactly the same. He does not change along the way. But most people have got this dichotomy. They've got this new Jesus for the new covenant era who really doesn't care about anything. And that new Jesus that they've got, and if that's how you're thinking, a dichotomy between the Jesus in the Old Testament and the Jesus of the New Testament, the reason is quite simply, you've got Satan in a Jesus suit. You have not got the one true living God in Jesus Christ himself. Okay.